Right, ladies and gentlemen, good morning, everybody. Here an explanation about exercise 28, where we're gonna calculate the skill factor. And before we calculate the skill factor, we need to measure some length. So you need to grab your ruler or protractor triangle because you will need it for this exercise. You will find in figure 8.41 on the right side dinosaurs and an enlargement of him. The dinosaur is the a very difficult name. 100 million years ago. Some extra information we do need to calculate with, because they ask you with A is to calculate the skill factor around to one decimal place. All right, what I'm gonna do is to grab to exactly the same points. So for example, I'm gonna measure from the top of his head, so the top of his eye, to under his mouth. Yeah, and I'm gonna measure the length from this point to the other one. And I will do exactly the same with the other drawing from here to there. Yeah, so you have two lengths from two in the exactly the same points, and we're gonna measure those two lengths. Well, if I measure them, then this line there is in my book 31 millimeters, and that line is 8 millimeters. Alright? So, to calculate your skill factor in exercise A, and we're gonna use the letter K for the skill factor, it is the distance in the image, so 31 millimeters, dividing with the corresponding distance in the object. Yeah, so this is the image, and this is the object. Yeah, so dividing with 8. Now, if I calculate that number, you will get 3.875. Yeah, and it's just three decimal numbers behind the comma. So, but they ask you to round at one decimal place, so it will be 3.9. Yeah, so the skill factor is 3.9. So if I multiply my 8 with 3.9, then it will be approximately 31 millimeters. Yeah, so everything is getting 3.9 times bigger, even the height of my dinosaurs. So round to one decimal place, calculate the height of the Dinosaurus, something like that, in the enlargement. All right. So, the height of the enlargement is, step number one is to measure the height of my small dinosaurs, and that's 27 millimeters in my book. So, 27 multiplying with the large with the skill factor, so 3.9, and that will be 105.3 millimeters. I calculate round to one decimal place. No, sorry, calculate the height of the dinosaurs for enlargements. So, and maybe if we do it in centimeters, it needs to be 10.53 centimeters. Maybe that's better. Yeah. Much better is if you use not the 3.9, because that number is rounded, but that you're gonna use, and maybe I need to use another color, that you do 27, because that's the height of my dinosaurs, multiply with the 31 over 8, because the 31 over 8 isn't rounded, even the number 3.875. Yeah, so if you calculate that one, then you get 104.625 millimeters. So that's 10.46 centimeters. Yeah, so that's the precise answer. Different if we just go on with a rounded number. Yeah, but in this exercise, it is allowed to go on with your rounded number, but much better is to use the 31/8. Right, so that was a explanation about exercise 28.